This video will demonstrate how to connect and set up the MPVS Ultra and C-Series Power Lab for small animal PV. Make sure you have installed LabChart and the PV Loop module, as well as the MPVS Ultra control software. Connect the MPVS Ultra to the same PC using the supplied USB cable. Connect the instrument interface to the PC using the provided interface cable. Connect the power cable to the MPVS Ultra and switch on the unit. The front panel of the MPVS Ultra has several inputs and outputs. Starting on the left, we have four input connectors. The grey connector is for the row cuvette, which is only used in large animal experiments. The green connector is used for connecting the external ECG through an interface cable and surface electrodes. The blue connector is for connecting a second pressure catheter, or for when a dual pressure PV catheter is used. Finally, the black connector is for connecting the PV interface cable, as shown here. Next to the input connectors, we have several B and C output connectors. The first group of two is for pressures. P1 is the pressure from the PV catheter, and P2 is from the PV catheter if it has two pressure sensors, or if a second standalone pressure is required. Here we will connect P1 to the first input on the C-Series instrument interface. Next to the pressure outputs, we have 8 outputs for volume. The first BNC is the composite output signal. This is the summation of 7 segments. The composite connector should only be used when recording from multiple segment catheters. For single segment catheters, we will connect S1 or segment 1 to the second input on the instrument interface. The last output is for the ECG signal, should you choose the green input as described earlier. We won't be using this output in this example. Connect the PV catheter to the interface cable. It is best to do this while the catheter is still in the anti-static pink foam, to safeguard against damage due to electrostatic discharge. Remember to soak the catheter in 37 degrees saline for at least half an hour before implanting. Start LabChart and the MPVS control software. Looking at the MPVS Ultra control interface, click on the orange Catheter Configuration Locked button. Now we can select the correct catheter in this list. For single segment catheters, this is all that needs to be done on this tab. Now, click on the Catheter Calibration tab. Next, click on the orange Balanced Locked button. We are now able to zero the sensor. With the catheter sensor just below the saline surface, click on Auto Zero. P2 won't be zeroed now, as we don't have a second pressure sensor connected. In LabChart, select the PV Loop menu and check Workflow. This will open the workflow window on the left. First, select the workflow. In this case, it's small animal. Next, indicate which channel in LabChart is the pressure channel and which channel is the volume channel. Now go to the next item in the workflow list, pressure calibration. Click on Start Sampling. Now move over to the control interface and click on the 25mm mercury button, and then after a couple of seconds, click on the 100mm mercury button, then back to transducer. In LabChart, stop the recording. Select the data that reflects the 25mm of mercury step, as shown, and click on the first arrow. The selected value will be placed here. This voltage is equivalent to 25mm of mercury, so type this into the second box. Repeat for the 100mm of mercury step, as demonstrated here. Check the box in front of Apply Pressure Calibration. Now that the pressure has been calibrated, we will calibrate the conductance. Select Conductance Calibration and again start sampling. Move over to the control interface and click on the blue button to display conductance values. The button is now orange. As with the pressure calibration, click on 1.14 millisiemens and 2.78 millisiemens and then back to transducer. Back in LabChart, stop the recording and this time select the step changes in the volume channel corresponding to the two conductance values and fill them into the calibration boxes as shown. Now click Apply Conductance Calibration. Additionally, one can rename the channels by right-clicking on the channel name and then renaming the channel, as shown here. The system is now ready to start recording PV data.